little place like the Cube.
Family, it's your favorite queer radio personality, Anna Deshawn, here on E3 Radio, representing for the Cube. And I am in the presence of a freaking icon, a hero, everything to everybody who has been doing the work for decades at this point and makes it possible for me to do the work that I'm doing, because you fought and you keep fighting for us. And so there's so many questions in my head, and I'm just gonna try to get them out of my mouth, okay? Y'all stay with me. I wanna say thank you, and I wanna know, in the midst of everything that's happening today, all the anti-trans legislation that's been happening, are you surprised by any of it?
No, not at all, because that's what they do. They cover it, let you relax, feel good, and then they take it away. And so they took it away. But we're gonna get it back. We have to get it back. And we're winning. So that's important.
So why do you think we're winning right now? A lot of people would say, but feel like we're not winning. Feel like this right-wing nationalist, racist, transphobic politicians are winning every time they turn around, something is happening. Why do you think we're winning?
Those motherfuckers don't give a damn about what they do. They're interested in destroying the government. They're interested in just mucking things up. In fact, this session, they didn't do anything. 22 laws came out. You know, they don't want to work. They don't want to do anything. We won, you know. But we have to fight it, you know. We can't be complacent. We can't sit around twiddling our thumbs or doing something else. Or running into a closet and hiding. You know, burn the fucking building. There's no time for that shit. We have to stand up, be counted, and then make them pay for what they're doing.
That part, pay for what they're doing and the harm that they're causing.
Yes.
Right? And from that angle, absolutely we're winning. Right? So, I was on a podcast recently called Bad Queers. Shout out to Bad Queers Pod. And they have this segment called Bad Queer Opinion. And my bad queer opinion is that white gay men stopped fighting after marriage equality. They just left the fight, left all their money. You know, how do we hold white gay men accountable to showing up for us?
Well, you know, if they show up, there's a few of them. But they don't. But those that don't want to show up, we don't need them. You know, we need the ones that believe in us and will stand up and admit that. If you stand up or you don't, you know, and if you stand up, you're gonna get counted. When you get counted, you're gonna mean something. So fight them. You know, when they get tired of their back into the cover, burn that motherfucker down. There's no shit in that shit. No. Yes, burn it down.
If you leave nothing with nothing today, burn it down is the message that we want to share to you. I love that. So today, right, aging, being queer, being who you are, I feel like there's not enough advocacy happening around taking care of our queer elders and those that are aging. How can the community better support, you know, our elders?
They can talk to them. And I mean, you know, they have stories to tell. They have life experiences, you know, that these young kids don't have. And if they find somebody, they should listen to them and take that on, you know, because then they won't have to go through this shit all over again, you know.
Because history does, in fact, repeat itself.
And they just don't see it, you know, and they should see it, because it's plain as day, the nose on your face.
It is, isn't it? So the one question we've been asking people is, how are you cultivating queer joy for yourself in 2024?
Joy? Child, I step outside my backyard and I put my feet in the grass and wiggle my toes. That's it. I just relate to nature. And it's there for you if you want it, you know. And you gotta see it, you know. And you, oh, yeah, but I flowered it. Don't need that shit. Yeah, you do. You need every one of them. Yeah? So get it and go and do it. That's all.
Go find some grass, put my feet in it, that's it.
Thank you, and move your toes.
Okay, I'm gonna do this. When I'm gonna edit this video, I'm gonna find my, well, I might have to get my feet done first, Miss Major. I don't know.
Who cares?
Okay. All right.
Does look like it fucking is. Period.
And that is all. Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.